Hello?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Is this Jose Rubio?
This is I.
Okay, hold on one second. Mr. Rubio, this is Jen Corbett. I wanted to talk to you before I got everybody on the line.
Yes, ma'am. This is me and my parents that are present right now, Michael.
All right, well, first of all,
how's it going?
Thank you for sending me the documents, but let me tell you something. Your power of attorney, based on what you've given me, that expired.
I'm sorry?
Your power of attorney is so good. You put an expiration date of 4/28/20 in your document, so it's expired. Second of all, power of attorney is not recognized by the
We actually sent you the wrong one, and so we sent the revised version, so you'll get the right one. The power of attorney can be given to anyone. And that is the due process of law.
Judge, are you threatening him?
Are you ruling from the bench? Is that what you're doing?
I'm telling you, you cannot do that.
The power of attorney can be given to anyone. You can't be making threats.
Okay. I'm not making any threats.
Yes, you are. You just threatened to throw him in jail. You did.
No, I did not.
Yes, you did. You said you would hold him in contempt. What does that mean?
Well, it can mean I could fine you or I could do other things. I said I would hold
him. Are you making threats again? Is that what judges do?
No, I'm not making threats. I'm telling you.
Okay.
I'm not going to talk to you if you don't listen.
You need to listen to us, because crimes have been committed.
Is this Mr. Rubio?
Yes, ma'am. This is Rubio here now.
Mr. Rubio, dear. Let me explain. The power of attorney does not work in a Texas court. If you're not a licensed attorney, you cannot represent someone in a Texas court. Therefore, I will not recognize the power of attorney.
No, we don't understand, because you know what? I have full power of attorney, and if you try to do anything to interfere with that right, then I mean that means you're going to what? Do you have a bond? Because I want to know if someone's going to interfere with my right. Are you bonding? Can you please present your oath of office? That's all we're asking before we even proceed.
You may inquire to get those from the Secretary of State if you wish to a copy of the oath of office that would be the proper venue for you to go.
There was some instruments that were filed in there illegally, and we have to prove that. Okay? Yes, ma'am. You were saying?
Thank you for your documents. I will forward them to the appropriate people. I will also forward the power of attorney to the state bar. I can't remember you, but if you can understand that I cannot.
No, you can't do that. You cannot do that. He is a American bloodline native. Equivalent to a state national. I mean, I don't know where y'all think that's getting y'all's authority over him. He is sovereign, and so I am. So, if y'all are going to proceed, then y'all agree to proceed without y'all's immunities. I mean, so is that what's going to happen? Because
I'm not answering any questions from you, so thank you so much for talking.
Okay, so now you have been advised, okay?
Thank you very much, sir, and you have been advised that the court.
What? You don't have any jurisdiction over me because I'm state national. Please tell me where you get that authority to speak to me.
Thank you very much.
You're going to leave this man alone, but we're going to hold you for capital.
And that right there is where Judge REVA TOWSLEE CORBETT of the 335th. District Court of Burleson County, Caldwell, Texas. She called me at 10:27 a.m. on May 4th, 2020 over the court phone. Cause number 30007. And this is Jose speaking.